Hello everyone. In this lecture, we will learn about different diode clippers and clamper circuits. To understand the diode clipper and clamper circuits, first we have to learn about the basics of diode biasing. If we remember these basic conditions, then it is very easier to learn clipper and clamper circuits. And this is very basic things. So as we know that if you apply positive voltage to the positive side of the diode and negative voltage to the negative side of the diode, then it is known as the forward biasing condition. And if you apply the reverse of that, that is the negative voltage on the positive terminal of the diode and positive voltage on the negative terminal of the diode, then it is known as the reverse biasing conditions. That is well known. But what happens when we apply positive voltages on both the terminals of the diode? In that condition, we have to remember that for the forward bias condition, the P side should have more positive voltage than N side. And the second condition is that the N side should have more negative voltage than the P side. Only in these two conditions, the diode can be in forward bias conditions. In all other conditions, the diode will be in reverse bias conditions. So always remember that if P side is more positive than N side, or N side is more negative than P side, then diode is in reverse bias. Okay. In all other conditions, the diode will be in reverse bias conditions. So this is the condition in which P side is less positive than the N side, or you can say N side is more positive than P side, but N side should be more negative than P side. So this is reverse bias conditions. In this condition, P side is more positive than N side. So this is forward bias condition. In this condition, both the terminals have negative potential, whereas the P side is less negative than N side, or you can say N side is more negative than P side, and that should be the case. So this is forward bias. Whereas in this condition, P side is more negative than N side. N side is negative, but P side is more negative. So in this condition, this is a reverse bias conditions. So we must remember all these conditions to understand the diode clipper and clamper circuits. So let's start the clipper circuits. So clipper circuits can be divided into two different types: positive series clippers and negative series clippers, or positive shunt clipper or negative shunt clippers. So this is the circuit of positive series clipper. This is series. Why? Because diode is in series with the supply. This is shunt. Why? Because diode is in parallel or shunt with the supply. So if you apply this voltage to this circuit, what happens that in the positive half cycle, the diode will become reverse biased, because this is positive voltage is applied to the negative terminal of the diode. So this will become reverse biased. So in series and shunt circuits, we must remember two things. First is that in series circuits, if the diode is forward biased, then it will become short and it will allow all the signals to pass to the load. Okay. But when the diode is in reverse bias condition in series circuit, the diode is open and it will not allow any signal to pass to the load. Okay. Whereas in shunt circuit, it is just opposite of the series circuit. In this condition, what happens that when diode is forward biased, it becomes short and there is no signal that is passed to the load. All signals are going through this path, because this is shorted and this has some resistance, and always the current follows the least resistance path. So this will become short and all the signals will pass through this path only, and there is no signal that reaches the load. So in this shunt circuits, we must remember that when diode is forward biased, no signal is passed to the load, and when diode is reverse biased, this is open and all the signals are passed to the load. So what happens in this circuit that when we apply some positive voltage to the diode, this becomes open circuited because this is reverse biased and no signal is passed to the load. Whereas in negative half cycles, this becomes forward biased and all the signals are passed to the load. So the all the positive half cycles are clipped and all the negative half cycles are passed to the load. So this is a positive clipper. Likewise, in shunt circuit also, when we apply a positive wave to the circuit, what happens? The diode becomes forward bias because we are applying positive to the P terminal of the diode. So in this condition, this becomes short and all the signals are passed through this path only, and there is no signal that reaches to the load. So in this condition, positive half is clipped. Whereas in negative half cycle, what happens that in negative half cycles, the diode is reverse bias because then this is open circuited, and in this condition, all the signals are passed to the load. So we get all the negative half cycles, whereas all the positive half cycles are clipped. Now, the negative series clipper and negative shunt clipper. What happens in this circuit is that when we apply some positive voltage to this diode, the diode becomes forward biased and all the positive peaks are passed to the load like this. Whereas in negative half cycle, what happens that the diode becomes reverse biased because we are applying negative voltage to the positive terminal of the diode. So diode becomes reverse biased and that is open circuited. So source is disconnected with the load. So we do not get any negative peaks in the output waveform. And what happens in the negative shunt clipper is that when we apply some positive voltage to the circuit, the diode becomes reverse biased because we are applying positive voltage to the negative terminal of the diode. So diode becomes reverse biased and it becomes open. So all the positive waves are passed to the load. Whereas in negative half cycle, diode becomes forward biased and it becomes shorted. So all the signal is passed through this path only, and there is no signal that reaches the load. So we do not get any negative peaks in the output waveform. So these were the positive and negative series and shunt clippers. Now next is the practical circuits. Here we have assumed that the diode is a ideal one. Ideal one means that there is no voltage drop across the diode in all the circuits. But practically we must have some voltage drop across the diode. So the positive clipper must have some positive voltage here, and in negative clippers we also have some negative voltage here. These are the 0.7 volt voltage drop across the diode. Okay, so practically we have this type of a form at the output. Now we also can apply some biasing voltages to the circuits that we have learned. Biasing voltage can be applied anywhere in the circuit, like here or with the resistance also. But when we apply biasing voltages, in that conditions we must analyze the biasing position of the diode. That means the diode is in which biasing condition. Is it reverse biased or forward biased? And for that we must analyze the first table that we have learned in the first slide. So when we are applying this polarity of voltage, that means negative is applied to the negative terminal of the diode. That means when we apply zero input voltage, in that conditions diode is forward biased. Now for all the future examples and this example, we will assume that this voltage is 2 volt, V is 2 volt, and the V max or negative V max is plus 5 volt or minus 5 volt. So let's assume that this is 2 volt and the input voltage is increasing. So if this input voltage is less than 2 volt, in that condition the resultant output voltage is the resultant supply voltage is negative, and in that condition the diode is in forward bias condition. So up to this point we will get the output as the input signal is changing. But as soon as the input voltage is more than 2 volt or more than this voltage, in that condition the resultant voltage is positive, and therefore the diode becomes reverse biased and we will not get any output voltage at that time. Again, as soon as the voltage decreases and it becomes negative, in all the negative voltage conditions the polarity, or you can say the resultant polarity here, will be negative, and in that condition we will have a forward bias conditions, and we will get all the output voltages in as the input voltage is changing, and the peak will be the V max plus V, that means this voltage plus this voltage. Okay, now let's take a next example in which the polarity of voltage is reversed. In this condition, what happens that this is in reverse bias conditions, and again we will take in this this voltage as 2 volt and this voltage as 5 volt. So for all the positive half cycles, the resultant output the resultant input voltage will be positive, and the diode will remain in reverse bias condition, and we will not get any output voltage as it is shown in this figure. So for all the positive half cycles, the diode will remain reverse bias. Now when we are going to the negative side of the peak, and the input voltage or input supply is less than minus two volt or this voltage, so in that conditions also the resultant voltage is positive, and we will have reverse bias condition on the diode. But when it increases from this voltage minus 2 volt or minus V volt to more than let's assume minus 3.5 volt, so minus 3.5 volt and 2 volt, we have a minus 1.5 volt negative voltage. So in this condition the diode is forward bias condition, and as soon as the diode becomes forward bias, we will have output voltage as the input voltage. So we will have this type of waveform. Again, this voltage is V max minus V, that means this voltage minus this voltage. Now let's reverse the polarity of the diode. In this condition, we are applying negative voltage to the positive side of the diode. So for all the negative half cycles, we have a resultant negative voltage. So for all negative voltages, we have reverse bias diode, and we will get nothing at the output. But for the condition when the input voltage is more than this voltage, the diode will become forward bias, and for that condition only we will get output, like as shown in the figure. So for the condition when the input voltage is more than this voltage, only for that condition we will have output voltage, and for all the remaining conditions we will have zero output voltage. Now let's reverse change the position of the biasing voltage from this position to this position. Now what is the output voltage? In this condition, the N side of the diode is given positive voltage. So the diode will become forward bias for only cases where P side of the diode is more positive than N side. So for the case when this voltage is more than input voltage is more than this voltage, for only those conditions we will have output voltage. In this condition, the P side is given positive voltage, so naturally the diode is positive in forward bias condition. So in this condition we will get output voltage for all the conditions in which the diode is forward bias. And when this side of the voltage is more than this voltage, for that condition only the diode will become in reverse bias position, and the diode will be open circuited, and in that condition we will get zero output, or we have a V output at the output. So we will have this type of waveform at the output. Now some shunt clipping circuits. In these conditions we have to analyze again the biasing conditions of the diode. So in this condition, the diode is in forward bias conditions, as the positive voltage is applied to the positive terminal of the diode. So in this conditions, the diode will become a reverse bias only for the condition when this voltage or input voltage is more than this applied voltage. So we will get this type of the output waveform. In this condition, again the diode is forward bias because we are applying negative potential to the diode. So again the diode will become reverse biased only for only conditions when this voltage is more than this voltage. So we have this type of output waveform. So we will continue this lecture in next video. Thank you.